Joan comes home. She props up a for sale by owner sign. Sucks in a huge gasp of air. She explores.
I go around moping and I go around blue. I made you cry for I had been untrue.
She dumps her stuff in the master bedroom upstairs and goes to work. Sweeps the ceiling of cobwebs, curling paint, unwraps rotten furniture, and burns the junk. There's no water. She wants to go down in the basement, but she stops.
Hey, turn on the water down there.
She's messing in territory where she shouldn't. Joan retreats. Walks into the scabby woods, hemlock trees with a soup of steaming leaves. Melders. Institute of Mental Hygiene. Someone watches. Joan clutches the fence and rust crumbles.
She's home. She's home. She's home. She's home. She's home. She's home.
Ed Doc speaking.
Ted, it's time for Trickler to talk.
Send him down to Dr. Hazard.
Joan closes the closet, the bathroom door, the door to the black hallway.
Thank you.
Hazard, you're working with the bracer today.
Wonderful. Thanks.
And head doctor is giving the assignment to work with Trickler. It won't be easy. It'll be traumatic.
No, thanks. I'll go easy on him.
They keep my office in the basement. Day one, therapy.
Oh, hello there. Hi, I'm Dr. Hazard. Well, I'd like to make friends, so come on in and we'll talk a little bit. Now, what might be your name? That's good enough. Mr. Trickler, you know, I looked in your file here and I didn't see much. I did see that one of the other patients heard you whispering in your sleep once, and, you know, I sure would like to hear that handsome voice of yours. Let me just take that for you and put it over here for a minute. Mr. Trickler, I'm here to help you relax and get rid of all your anxieties. Now just breathe deeply. You may even find your eyes closing. You know, you don't even need to listen to my voice, really, because the words will just simply drift into your subconscious through the doors of your mind with every word I speak. Another door.